Last week I introduced the technique of ABC-active and CaWa-active. But can you really record information in context if you only write down individual words? Today I make the self-test with an ABC-active which I created 11 months ago. This one here is an interesting one. It's from an article by Smithsonian, and it's about do trees talk to each other. It's very, very interesting. It's about approximately 1 year ago, on the 27th of July 2019, I read through this and I recorded the ABC active. So let's say, what have we got here? Acacia is a type of tree. And acacia, and I think it is the acacias, they can become bitter. For instance, if they're infested by caterpillars. And the thing is, if a caterpillar infests one acacia tree, that acacia tree can turn bitter so that they don't taste any so well anymore. But not only this tree, also the neighboring trees, which have not yet been invaded by caterpillars, they also produce a chemical which makes them bitter, so that caterpillars and other animals are less likely to chew on the leaves. So it seems that these trees are talking to one another. And so we have under D a distress signal. One plant produces a chemical that is taken up by other plants, which then change their behavior based on that. And the distress signal, because the acacia tree, for instance, is attacked by caterpillars. Then what do we have here? Deer. I think the deer goes with the Douglas fir, if I remember correctly. And it is a similar story. And I know we have elm here. Do we have other trees? And pine tree. I don't know exactly anymore which of them go with which animal. I can't remember that, but I can remember that each of those, like caterpillar, deer, we have giraffe. They don't have any other animals. All of those, they're basically eating the plants, and the acacia, Douglas fir, elm, and pine, they're the plants being eaten. They're all sending out the distress signal. Another interesting, and this is something, a distress signal that goes through the air. Another interesting way of communicating, if you like, goes by directed nutrient flow. And this one goes through a fungus networks in the roots. And so the trees are able to send nutrients from one tree to another. So basically older trees can nourish younger trees, which are not yet big enough to get enough sunlight. Ethylene gas, this is basically an agent which helps, it's a volatile, it's called a volatile, that means it's a chemical compound that can very easily go into a gaseous state and be carried by the wind. So they use ethylene gas among other gases, among other chemical compounds, to send the distress signal, for instance. I already said fungal network that goes with direct nutrient flow. That's how they communicate. Then they have here feeding. Yes, via the directed nutrient flow, the trees can feed other trees. Forest stabilization. It seems that by this fungal network and by this feeding, because more younger trees could survive than could otherwise survive, that this stabilizes the forest. Otherwise, more trees would die and then they would fall and then they would need to be replaced by other ones. But this stabilizes which plants you have in a given forest. Giraffe already said. Hormones. Yes, this distress signal is caused by hormones. So as the plant is being chewed on, as it's being eaten, basically there is some, they don't have a nervous system as such, but they have something a little bit similar using hormones. In our bodies, we also have hormones, but plants using hormones exclusively, to the best of my knowledge, and that then sends out the ethylene gas as the distress signal. We also have healing agents. So basically, plants not only communicate with other plants, but certain cells, certain organs and plants also communicate with one another via the hormones. And then another type of cell maybe releases a healing agent. Horse logging, well, this has something to do with using horses instead of modern machinery for logging. And that had a certain impact. It was better for the plants, I think, but I can't remember why. Then we have a hub tree. A hub tree has to do with a directed nutrient flow via the fungal network. The hub tree sends out the nutrients. And we have interspecies alliance because the fungus and the trees via the fungal network, they enter an alliance. That means basically, actually the fungus gets something. They also get nutrients from the trees, but the trees also get something because they can send nutrients to other trees. Into the wind browsing. Oh, this is very interesting. This is really interesting, guys. Into the wind browsing. I think it's what the giraffe does. When they are chewing on the plants, they're going from the downwind direction. So basically the wind comes from that direction. Here is the tree. And the giraffe comes from there. Because trees like acacia trees, they are sending out this distress signal. But the distress signal is windborne, is airborne, it's carried by the wind. So if the giraffes come from the downwind direction, the plants, upwind of the plants they're chewing on at the moment, can't be warned because all of the distress signals goes downwind where the giraffes have already been. So that's a very clever adaptation. Leaf nose, that's basic. Oh, you can't see it, hang on. Here, leaf nose, this is a very... It's basically that the leaves, they can act as noses, so to speak, in a sense of a nose, our nose, is used to detect volatile chemicals in the air. And similarly, the leaves of plants can detect, not only take in CO2, which the plants need to do their photosynthesis, but they also take in other chemicals and they analyze these chemicals and then they can react to the distress signal. Mother tree, this is similar to hub tree. Network decoupling. I can't actually remember why decoupling. I mean, network, I think it goes to fungal network. What is decoupled? How the network is decoupled from one another? I can't remember. Pine. I said before. Then we have ripping soil. Yes, now I also know more about the horse logging. The ripping soil is the horses, they don't damage the soil as much as modern machinery. And because modern machinery damages the soil much more, they're ripping the soil. They're destroying this fungal network. And that means they're doing much more harm to the forest than horse logging, because they're not only taking away members from that network, they're not just taking some trees offline, but they're destroying large parts of the network. So you have sort of a blackout in the network, if you like. Then we have this one here, is called root tip recognition. This has something to do with the fungal network. I think it has something to do with that the roots, the tips of the roots, they also act as sensors similar to the leaves. They can also recognize certain chemicals. And so the roots, they grow in a certain direction. If there is a certain chemical in this part of the soil, they will grow preferentially into this rich, abundant source of minerals, of nutrients. So the root tips can recognize things, which is really cool. Service fee sugar. So basically the service fee sugar goes back to the fungal network. And I said before, we have an interspecies alliance. Both partners have something of it. And actually what the fungus gets from this fungal network is they get sugar, and they get sugar from the trees. And this is sort of the service fee. Once the tree pays the sugar, the fungus is happy, if you like this, to send the messages of the trees. Then we have sound emission. Do trees also emit sound? I can't remember that. There must be something that, because all of this is about do trees talk. So they seem to be able to emit sound. I have to read this again. I can't remember. Saliva detection. That's basically if an animal chews on the plants, how does the plant detect that it's being chewed on? Well, the saliva of the animals has certain chemical compounds, and the tree can detect this chemical these chemical compounds in the saliva, and thus send out the distress signal or the healing agents, the bitterness signals, and all of that inside the tree and also towards other trees. Voltage signaling. I only remember that animals use voltage signaling. I suppose there will be some voltage signaling in plants, not via neurons, not via nervous cells, but what exactly I meant, I can't remember anymore. And then wood wide web, this is just a funny way of referring to this fungal network in analogy to the world wide web. It's a wood wide web, it's a forest wide web. So yeah, out of how many have I got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Basically, out of 30 words, I could not remember two of them. One of them was sound emission. One of them was voltage signaling. Three of them. And the network decoupling. I can't remember exactly what I meant by those three. Horse logging, I remembered later when I read Ripping Soil, but that means 27 words or 90% I can remember, and I remember what this article was about, what it was talking about, even some details, although I haven't looked at this article in 11 months. That's pretty amazing, actually. Well, there you have it. It is really possible to recall a lot of context information even though I just written down individual words and played a little bit with the words later. If you're interested in the original article, you'll find a link in the description. And as always, if you found the video useful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos on how to think deeply and creatively. And I'll see you in my next video.